plenty of BrummyAdz here. Welcome back to more Red Dead Redemption 2 walkthrough. So straight into it. I'm almost there. This one here.
Selling it back to where it came from.
Why?
I ain't got a market for it. They made it, they must have someone to sell it to. Stuff look kind of lonely out here. I think we'll cut ourselves a deal.
I ain't risk it at all.
You and Dutch was just doing your duty when you requisitioned it. Now I'm doing mine.
All right. I should get going now. I'll leave you fellas to it. Good luck.
Thank you, John. We'll see you later. Dutch asked him to look into something to do with the Braithwaite horses, I think.
Sure, okay.
Okay, let's head out to the Braithwaite's place. You know the way?
Yeah, I've been there. So, what exactly are we doing? This is the moonshine we took after blowing up the Braithwaite still, right?
I think the good citizens taking the trouble to return their stolen goods deserve some reward, don't you? And it's time we made a formal introduction, like Dutch told us. Look, these are two big old plantation houses. All I keep hearing is they hate each other so much they can't see past it.
I know. I've seen it. There's a gray boy and a Braithwaite girl carrying on a secret affair. I've been, well, helping them.
The mind boggles. You think they're of use?
Not sure. They don't seem too involved in the rest of it, but maybe.
Well, I'm sure there's money in this for us somewhere if we can get in the middle of it.
Hello, gentlemen, how are you?
What's that in the back there?
Moonshine, my fine fellow. May I have a word with the man of the house?
The man of the house is a lady. Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
May I speak with her? I want to discuss a business opportunity. I mean no harm. No harm at all. You may happily shoot me if I do.
Okay. Well, she's at the house. We'll be watching you.
You heard the man. Driver, proceed, please.
Driver, you know.
Thought maybe you was in the market for it.
For what?
Some liquor.
I ain't in the market for what's already mine.
The way we see it, it's out. Well, with us possessing it, and I checked all over. For the life of me, I couldn't see your name on it. Oh. Relax, I ain't here to rob you. Oh, it seems that's easy enough. Why not do a deal? What do you sell that stuff for?
Dollar a bottle.
Give us 50 cents.
It's already ours.
Well, look on it as a reward for finding the property. Alternative is we go sell it someplace else.
The alternative is you get shot.
Now, well, you will die.
You get shot over a bottle or two of liquor.
Pay the man.
Pleasure doing business with you. And listen, we didn't take it, at least not without orders.
Oh, I know exactly who gave you your orders. Old Sheriff Gray. You know what? I don't want it. In fact, sir, now you can do me a favor. There's an extra $10 if you do. Drive the stuff into Rhodes, head over to the tavern run by Mr. Gray, and give the stuff out for free.
Mama!
Hush now. I believe they call that a promotional expense.
As you wish, madam.
You boys come back sometime and tell me how you made out. Maybe we'll play a little cribbage.
All right. Next stop, the Rhodes Saloon.
Here we go.
Yeah, the house would burn down later on again.
Got close to 1,000 for them. Wanted more, but not bad considering how hot they were, especially after that bloodbath in Valentine.
No, not bad at all.
Apparently, Cornwall's been pumping a lot of cash into the Pinkertons. Wants to keep their full effort on going after gangs. Gangs like us.
Yeah. That don't surprise me.
All right. This could get ugly. You and Dutch already have that thing going on in town with the sheriff.
Yeah, Mr. Gray.
That's it. Now we're inserting ourselves in his blood feud. We'll need something.
I ain't playing, Jesse. You know how I feel about that.
Of course you're not. You're a clown's idiot brother.
Hosea, please.
I'm the clown. You're the idiot. Just look sad and keep quiet. Even you can do that, Arthur.
Oh, I have to.
Put this hat on. Smoke this pipe. Bring your lip forward just a bit. Squint.
Oh, perfect. What about you?
Oh, shh. You sorry, can't mate. Speak. You're turned idiot. My broke poor man is hot. There.
What's the train on that map? Let's quick look at that real quick. Oh, no. Oh, yeah, I can rob them, can't I?
There. Don't get mad now.
Keep it and stay calm now. For Mama, she loved you so.
Just a shame you had to strangle her in a rage, right? Grab two cases of that stuff and follow me.
But it weren't his fault. How'd you boys like a couple of bucks?
I bet you would. One for each of you.
We're in the new trade of advertising, which is an American art form about ensuring people buy the correct things.
I don't know.
One more dollar. Says give us half an hour. What harm can we do in half an hour? Go along now. Enjoy the money. Come along, Fenton. Just hand out the liquor. Gentlemen, my name is Milton. That's my brother Fenton. He's a bit funny, but boy, can he pour drinks fast. For the next 30 minutes, the drinks in this here bar, in this here town, are entirely free. Yeah. The only rule is that you gotta drink them. So hurry up, put old Fenton to work. Don't get him mad, though. His mama made him mad, and we buried her. Poor thing. Now come up to the bar, everybody. Come on, fellas and children.
I'll have one, Ben.
Drinks. A gift. Bounty. It's a shame to look at you.
Huh? That's some strong stuff.
Just keep them coming.
See them all catch us.
So what I do is serve drinks.
Mr. Gray won't be happy about this.
Ben, open another bottle.
Cup, where's mine then?
Don't be shy, boys.
You're
quiet libation.
You?
Me?
You're the bastards who stole the liquor we was gonna buy.
Gentlemen, we're in advertising. Come on in and have a drink.
That's our goddamn liquor.
An honest mistake.
Boys, get him!
On my shirt.
No, are they?
Ah! Over there! They got out the back!
You bear a bat!
Hide us on there, coming out of the alley!
Whoa.
I see it.
Made it.
In front of you, Arthur.
You see any more of them?
Don't think so. Jesus, all this over a few bottles of booze?
I reckon it's more they don't want another gang on their patch.
Okay. Set us up.
No, I don't think so. Maybe. This place is odd.
Keep seeing those folks.
Some local militia. Clearly not too happy to have some new competition. I'll go visit old Ma Braithwaite. See what's what.
Why?
We've been making money. The chest is filling up again, slowly but surely. Part of me thinks we just get ourselves good and lost. But we still need a lot more money before that can happen. So, for now, let me go give old Mrs. Braithwaite some of this moonshine as, well, let's call it a peace offering.
Sure.
That was fun, Fenton. We'll make an actor of you yet.
I'll go speak to Dutch.
What do you think?
About what?
Fine folks around these parts.
Oh, real nice.
Exactly. On the one side, we have got the Gray family. Scots, degenerates, drunkards, the local law. You couldn't make this stuff up. Rich as Croesus. And on the other, their mortal enemies, the Braithwaites. Moonshiners, hypocritical, both rolling, we believe.
In gold. And in the middle of it all, you got some inbred retelling of Romeo and Juliet.
Exactly.
So what you boys thinking?
We try to rob them both.
You sure?
Why not?
Because we got lawmen in three different states after us.
The last thing I want is to get us into trouble, but we need money. Now, we have the opportunity here to put ourselves in the middle of something ain't nobody gonna know we was here. Because even without us, these fools are gonna kill each other anyway.
Okay, well, Hosea's gone back to see that Braithwaite woman.
Good. Hosea should definitely take the lead on this. I sent Sean over to Braithwaite Manor, too. Now, you can meet up with them. Or join John and Javier at the Gray's place. Something to do with the Braithwaite's prize horses.
How the hell did we get an inn at the Gray's place?
Sheriff Gray kindly put in a word with his father. It ain't that complicated. We gotta convince each family that we're on their side. And then we rob them both. Before they figure out it was us that done it, and not the other lot, we'll be long gone. Think of it as payback for my daddy.
Payback. I ain't in the revenge business, Dutch. Least of all for something happened a long time ago.
Well, I guess we all gotta pay for something. Now, if you will excuse me, Arthur, I got to write a letter.
Alright, okay, that's that done. Closer, let's do this. It's closer.
Evening, Arthur.
Good work on that bank job.
Loved every minute.
There'll be plenty more where that came from. Where's that horse got to?
Here she is.
Yep.
Should tell me not to get that mission. I'll just get in there.
Howdy!
Hi there, mister.
Won't disagree with you there.
Hey, fellas. I have a meeting with Mrs. Braithwaite. My associates are already here.
All right, that's enough. Move along now.
Someone ever hit my horse.
This way, sir. A gentleman to see you, ma'am.
So, your friend, the other liquor vendor. Hello.
Hello, ma'am.
Arthur, welcome. We're just playing cribbage. Arthur Morgan, Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
Nice to see you again.
Apparently. So this one, he is big and as dumb as he looks?
Well, he's surely big, but his intelligence is a matter of some conjecture. Some say he is as dumb as he looks, but I think, well, he's not quite that dumb.
So these are the boys going to Callagher Hall?
Yes, we can take care of that for you, but one hates to be coarse. There is the question of money.
Oh, we've got money, Mr. Matthews.
Paper? Bonds? Metal?
She ain't gonna pay you in a certified check, you Yankee numbskull.
Ain't childbirth just the most beautiful miracle
on earth?
Seems a lady can birth monkeys, after all.
Give me someone to burn down the tobacco fields.
Hop on. Oil fill you in on the way.
No, I'm driving. Fine. We don't have time for this.
All right, let's get this over with.
You was quiet in there.
Took everything I had. That son of hers. I'll shove that silver spoon down his throat and pull it clean out of his arse. The smug fucker.
Okay. So what's she got us doing at the Gray's place?
She wants us to torture tobacco fields. Said they ain't had rain in weeks round here.
What?
Yep. Using that back there.
Moonshine?
Burns faster than kerosene, that stuff. Said it'd be fitting she did. All I'm thinking is how about I try fitting my boot up your hook? No, you snotty old bitch.
Jose really picked the right feller for tea in the manor, didn't he?
Ah, he was giving his usual flannin. One of these families got gold stashed somewhere, he reckons. I mean, I'm all for sticking it to rich folks. I hate rich folks. They really better be some bloody money at the end of all this.
Jose knows what he's doing.
Does he, though? The master finagler of nothing.
Easy, easy.
So far, we've destroyed the Braithwaite still. Tried to sell the shine back to them. Now we're on this fool's errand, which I'm very much looking forward to, by the way. They were saying old man Gray's double security
okay, go.
After that business at the saloon.
So,
thanks.
We're just gonna drive on in there, is that it?
Don't worry, I got a plan. Wagons go in and out of there all the time with supplies, equipment, payroll. Especially now they're taking on all that extra muscle.
We're making a delivery, that's all.
Just leave it to me. I can talk a dog off a meat wagon.
All right, then.
English.
Excuse me?
You not worried about them Greys?
In what sense?
Well, they knows you.
Maybe you're right. You know what? Here. I'll go hiding back. If you can act naturally. Stop us from getting into a fight before we're ready.
I will try.
Yes. Try and do an impression of a human being.
But I'm not going to go that far.
There was a thing at the saloon.
What you talking about?
Well, I'm delivering the supplies.
You're not the usual driver.
You want a bottle, friend? Here. Have a wee drop. I'm new. I mean you no harm. I've come from Donegal, in Ireland.
You don't say.
Yeah. They said you'd understand. Some kind of incident at the saloon in town. I was told to bring this up here. Ask no questions, I'll tell you no lies. Sort of business. Before the officials got there, they said.
Okay. Drive this way. I'll show you how to get there.
Oh, thank you, friend. Have a drink, Sean.
Hamish.
Good to meet you, Hamish. Fine bit of country you've got here. Not as fine as Connemara, but fine nonetheless.
My people come from Scotland.
Is that right? And you and I are nearly brothers.
Just over here. Straight down the path here. It's getting so I can barely keep track of all these deliveries coming in.
Yeah, and they said they was looking for more drivers in town. I jumped at the chance. I never been a feller to kick a bit of honest work out of bed. So, you folks been having a hard time of it, have you?
Yeah, Mr. Gray's got a heap of problems right now with another family around here. Bunch of covetous lowdowns trying to sabotage his livelihood. Disgusting.
Oh dear, I'm sorry to hear that, Hamish. Sounds like you definitely deserve that drink.
You don't know the half. Just in there.
Right there.
You can unload it here.
In here? Oh, the horse is like a swift one, do they?
Excuse me?
Nothing. It's grand. Quite a place you boys have got here. Reminds me of one of them big houses out in Donegal. Real fancy places they was, Hamish. Real fancy, because of some folks got all the money. The fanciest places imaginable, eh? Mm. Well, the average man sups on shite, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Okay, yeah. Come on, Arthur. What are you playing at?
I was enjoying the monologue. Glad I'm not your brother.
Where?
Let's get on with this.
I'm not the one who was dawdling.
How you getting on?
Good. Nearly got these things ready.
Okay. Plenty of guards out there. Here's how I feel we should deal with things. You head over to the dry barn.
Sure. And you?
I'm gonna deal with the fields themselves.
We coat everything in moonshine, and then we light things up with these little fellas here. Thankfully, it ain't rained. And that old barn over there should go up like a torch.
How many of these boys you think you need?
They should do it. Let's head out the back. Look, once they get wind of us, there'll be no turning back, so move quickly.
Of course. I'm rebel stock, boy. I was barn burning down manor houses.
We'll burn quietly.
Quiet. There's someone coming on the left.
I thought the wagon already arrived.
This one didn't.
Strange. So, what you got there?
Tools, payroll.
Okay. Drop it by the supply shed at the back of the fields.
Sure. See you later.
You hear that? Payroll.
Yeah. Let's get this job done first, okay?
Just let me deal with our friend here.
Thank you.
You douse the fields. I'll meet you at the barn.
Try to stay out of trouble.
Yeah, I have a best mission.
Should be enough for here.
I was trying to, don't know why it just did that. I had the thing in my eye and I was trying to drop some more moonshine. It's the last bit of it. Oops.
Just a quick dousing as well.
Let's go!
tools are right out of here.
You seem to be taking it well.
This is a goddamn mess.
I'm tired already.
Come on! The wagon we saw come in earlier. We can nick the horses from that.
Alright, where is it?
This one. Look out! Here come more of them! You pay for this! More guys coming in!
They didn't tell me nothing.
Down here, come on!
No way out of here. Jose, you better get us paid real well for this.
Bloody right. I'm gonna leave you
be. There it is. Maybe they haven't unloaded our cash yet.
Take those horses.
We're there, see if the payroll was actually in there.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy. We did good, Morgan. We did good.
Hey, but let's go.
Looky here, you get them horses, free marker. Come on.
Go on, girl.
Oh, what up, my,
into a life party.
You call that a party?
That Braithwaite had got a money's worth, Arlie.
Let's just get out of here first.
Interesting little fight Dutch has put us into the middle of here.
Yeah. I hope him and Jose are right and that there's some money at the end of it.
Well, what now?
Head on back to camp.
You coming?
Sure.
Oh, no.
Shh, girl. There, girl.
So I've got two horses now. Nice. sort of dodge out in a minute. Give me a sec, guys. I see my dog wants to go for a walk. Right, I'm back. I actually want to go out for a walk, which I don't mind. Saves me going out in the cold. I'm going to have a nice hot chocolate instead. I much need this hot chocolate. Right, let's get Dutch done. I got outside, I did make a nice hot chocolate.
Sweating yet, Dutch?
Of course I'm sweating. We're in some disease-ridden, swampy, Dixie-whistling shithole.
I meant about what Trelawney said about these bounty hunters.
Well, not sweating as such, but maybe a little gentle perspiration. Until we know more, ain't too much harm in wasting good liquor on sweating.
So?
So, I think you should pay Mr. Trelawney a visit and find out exactly what he knows and who he spoke to. Take Charles with you. Oh, the sight of the pair of you would make a statue sing out its secrets.
Okay. Charles, I need you for some business in town. Come on.
Okay.
I'll take you, Jesse.
Hey, girl.
I've got to buy a proper saddle and stuff for a horse yet.
Why are we stopped?
Waiting for you.
Where are we going? Dutch wants us to have a talk with Trelawney about these bounty hunters who are coming for us. Hoping he can tell us who they are or where they're coming from.
Okay. And you're deputies now.
Something like that.
I just got on the road.
As soon as we laid eyes on that fool of a sheriff who runs that town, I knew Dutch was gonna play him like a fiddle.
On the run from one bunch of lawmen, working for another. Interesting.
Hiding in plain sight, Dutch calls it. So, spirits seem good.
In the new camp, I mean.
We got some space between us and that mess now. Ain't seen no more Pinkertons for a while. There's these bounty hunters, of course, but Dutch don't seem too worried about it.
Can't believe they're still coming after us. We didn't even get away with the money.
Yeah, but they don't know that.
Of course. Trelawney. I've only met him a couple times, but he's a strange one.
Come on, we gotta stick together.
Don't slow down this.
Anyway, what were you talking about? Fear not. He's just a cockroach in fancy britches. But he gets into nooks and crannies the rest of us can't.
Easy.
What happened there?
Someone got here first.
So it seems.
By the looks of things, it wasn't a social call.
Check the house. This food's barely touched. Looks like he left in a hurry.
Found anything? You see anything there?
I
not made, so he must have been here recently.
Big struggle. Pretty recently, I'd say. I guess maybe 12 hours ago.
But no body?
Not yet. Look, tracks. Come on.
You all right, girl?
They went down the path here. How's your tracking these days?
All right, I guess.
Well, lead the way then.
Not the kind of place I'd expect to see Trelawney staying in.
No?
Normally scams himself into the best hotel in town.
You know, when me and Javier went down with Trelawney to get Sean, after the bar fight, I swear, he talked the whole way and never actually said a damn thing.
I thought you knew. That's his special talent. They could be 20 miles away by now.
We can track them. Far if we need to. Depends on how much you want to find them.
Yeah. I still ain't sure about that.
Huh. They seem to head into the forest now.
Hey, look. Let's go see what those fellas have to say.
Out of the way, man.
Excuse me.
Yeah?
Have you seen him? we're looking for our friend.
I don't think he's here.
you seen a strange sort of fella? Sort of formal?
Strange? Sure. Formal? Nah.
He uses a cane. Looks a lot like this one.
Yeah. All right, you two.
Where the hell is he?
You both better get out of here!
Come here! Yeah.
At least hit me proper.
You wanna come at me?
Bring it up! Tell me where he is.
You go to hell.
You better tell me now, you son of a bitch.
Okay, for Christ's sake. They took him to a cabin over by the cornfields.
Which cornfields?
Left. Down the path there by Braithwaite Manor. They'll be down a while. All right. That should do it.
That's a lot of them.
Follow me. I think there's a way around so we don't have to go through the Braithwaite place.
Yes. I've spent enough time there. After you, then.
Oh, God. Just back in there. Chip my chocolate.
You okay?
I'm good.
What do you think they want with Trelawney?
Could be any one of 100 things. Just depends if any of them involve us.
You think he'll talk?
Of course he'll talk. He'd sell his own sister to save a train fare. He don't know how not to talk. He don't know where we're holed up, though. At least I don't think he does.
I don't know why Dutch still deals with him. Always disappearing for weeks on end.
He's got his uses, and, well, loyalty matters to Dutch.
Of course. But is Trelawney loyal?
Yeah, kind of. I guess Trelawney ain't exactly disloyal.
Just got a big mouth. Don't worry. If he talked, I'll goddamn find out what he said. Nothing's ever straightforward where Trelawney's involved. Learn that much.
I mean, how much time have we wasted getting this fool out of trouble?
He somehow manages to be both lucky and unlucky at the same time.
That's one way of looking at it.
But he always finds some way to pay us back. Just when we think about cutting him loose, he brings us something big. I guess that's his special talent, keeping fish on the line.
After that shack, this will be remembered like a good time.
Put the man down, gentlemen. Is that the lot of them?
I think so.
So you're alive.
Allegedly.
Well, don't worry, they won't be for much longer.
Look, go get them, Arthur. I can handle this.
Sons of bitches.
We need to flush them out.
So, oh.
I think I heard something.
I
this
see
way.
One.
I only.
We got one more, Charles.
Look at the birds. Go that way.
Dumped his gear. Look around. He can't have gone far.
Keep searching. He's around here somewhere.
Let me take him. Get out of here.
You have my friend.
He's not your friend. I'll give you money.
Be quiet. Come on.
You should have taken the money.
I know. I'm a fool.
Shit. Thank you.
Of course. You okay?
Yeah. Shut his head clean off.
shots are coming from that barn. Come on. He's backing off inside. Get after him. There he is. Take him out. Let's go back for Trelawney. You all right?
Yeah. Never goes easy, does it?
Sure don't. Come on. Let's go see how badly they beat up the slippery fella.
I wonder how much trouble he's brought with him.
Guess we'll soon find out.
Seems like we can't catch a break now, Arthur.
Our luck's held this long. We got out of worse scrapes than this one.
So I heard.
Sure. What's government agents and bounty hunters to us?
I hope you're right.
Come on.
Getting on? Okay, cool. Meet you there.
Mr. Trelawney, where are you?
Over here, dear boy. Are you trying to abandon me?
You okay?
Never finer.
So, who was they?
They were bounty hunters. Attached to Cole Stoudemire.
Okay.
They weren't looking for me, per se.
What'd you tell them?
Not much. I told them I was an intellectual. Come down here from Oregon, looking for a job at the university. Of course, they didn't believe me. Seems you stirred up quite a hornet's nest in Blackwater.
So I keep hearing.
It might be best if I stay with you, gentlemen, for a while. Can't go back to that caravan now.
All right, Charles. You take Trelawney back to camp. I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
Have an easy one.
Bounty hunters, Pinkertons, lawmen. Everywhere we go. More and more civilization. Perhaps this is it from now on. We shall see, I guess.
Over it and head to John straight after.
How are you, girl?
Sitting in the wrong place.
Excuse me?
I didn't mean any offense, sir. Please.
I don't get your meaning.
I'm very sorry, sir. You have yourself a fine day, and I apologize for any offense I may have inadvertently caused.
What are you drinking, mister?
Nothing, sir. Nothing at all.
Why are you acting so strange?
I don't mean to. I'm sorry for any offense.
How could what? You have offended me?
I have no idea. But I had no idea how I offended the last fellas. And they stole my wagon on account of my impudence.
Stole your wagon for back check?
They didn't like my medical practice, I suppose. I was helping folk.
That wasn't popular?
I was undercutting the competition. Or I was too colored. Or I was irritating in nature. Or I was some know-it-all big city slicker here to demean some good old boys of my fine word. The exact variety of my sins was the source of some conjecture, so they undercut me.
That ain't very nice.
That was my impression. Still, compared to the gutting, castration, defenestration, and crucifixion they offered me. I felt like I'd off lightly.
Imagine it to a bunch.
Yes.
But
no great love for my medical practice. Too free with my wisdom and services.
Which way they go?
Down the road, that away.
Stay here.
I'm sort of forced to. Please don't go to any trouble on my account.
Mm-hmm.
Are you looking for that fella's wagon? I heard him say they was taking it to Macomb's Inn.
Okay, thanks.
How far was it? Don't. Oh. Why's it gotta be all the way over there? Ah. Oh, I hate doing these fucking type of stuff, man. They have to travel everywhere. Sorry. Out for now, guys, like I usually do, and I'll see you in the next part when I get there. I'm here. Quite quick, actually.
Doctor friend of mine lost his wagon. You all ain't seen it, have you?
I'll take him back to him.
Okay, come on. Get you back to the dock.
That's quite simple. Whoa. Expecting that. Okay. I did cut the video. That's why I'm traveling back.
Okay.
I didn't expect to run into anyone like that.
Not again.
I'll just hit some rick. Express. Mate, I'll be up so I can take over. Try and shoot me. They want to go up my way. What is that there? I'm past that before, didn't I? What is that? Fence. Oh. That's what I was looking for before, just have I got brick. What I've got.
You know this fella, don't you?
Look who it is. I did not count on seeing that wagon again. Nor you, for that matter.
The only people you won't be seeing are the folks that took it.
I take it they aren't the only ignorant bullying clodhoppers in these parts. But I can live in glorious hope. Now, it wasn't a trouble now, was it?
No, it was a pleasure.
Yeah, let me give you something for your pleasure.
You just walk through the horse.
This. Provide a man a tincture, he'll be well for a day. Teaching to make one, he might be well a while longer.
I'll make sure to try and make this. Thank you.
Thank you. It won't work for anything chronic, but you may not need it to. Well, if you see me on my travels and you're in need of something, make sure you come and say hello.
Travel safe now.
All right. To now. At camp. I thought I had a mission over here. So I thought it was, I was hidden.
That's that.
What's that, guys? What is that over there? I've got enough time to do one more mission, but what's this over here?
brother died. I saw my friends die, and I saw my leg.
Ouch.
Hey, mister. You give me some money? Thank you. Say, where you from?
Around.
Ain't from right here. If that was you, I'd leave. This town lost its goddamn soul a long time ago. Nothing but nasty, miserable people.
Yeah?
Yeah, ever since them Grays moved here. A bunch of no-good white trash. Yeah, they somehow got rich about 50 years ago. They moved here, caused a whole heap of trouble. Yeah, I reckon they was Yankee spies during the war and everything.
That's so.
Yeah, sure.
All right, folks.
Find another spot for loitering.
But I will knock your ass out.
Calm down.
This is John.
Hello, mister.
Listen, have you seen... I'm looking for my friend, Gavin.
I don't know any Gavins, I'm afraid.
English bloke. Lovely fella. He went missing and, now I'm all alone.
Good luck.
That's too bad.
Gavin! Hey, partner.
How do you do, sir?
Yeah, I tell you, life ain't easy.
Now that is a shame.
Anyway, sorry, you don't need to hear this.
You take care now.
Pretty sure John just wasn't too far away. Oops.
Alright,
let's have a look what John's mission was. So I knew it wasn't that far away. That's where I was gonna go originally.
Had some trouble.
Yeah, we had some trouble. Bad trouble. What you want?
Oh, I was supposed to meet some business partners here. They arranged a meeting, I believe.
Fellow with a scar and a Mexican?
Yes, sir.
How about the stables, I think?
Thank you. And, sorry for your troubles, friend.
Have you met my partner, Arthur Morgan?
No.
I met your son, the sheriff.
Okay.
Mr. Gray here was saying how he had problems with a family of degenerates.
Oh, well, nobody likes degenerates.
Hag and her inbred sons. They ruined this county. They killed my uncle, you know.
That ain't right.
Problem is, we can't be seen to get too close.
The end?
We've got gold, Yankee. We've got gold.
I ain't no Yankee, friend. I ain't nothing. My daddy came over on a boat from Scotland.
I'm Scottish.
And the Braithwaites?
Goddamn peasants. I don't know. Mongrels.
Slave fuckers. All you gotta do is look at them.
How much gold?
Enough. These are prize torches I'm talking about. Them will get you 5,000.
5,000? For horses?
Easy.
Where do we sell them, these $5,000 horses?
Over in Clemens Cove. Fellow over there will run them out of state and give you 50 cents on the dollar.
Mister, you got yourself a deal.
Just keep us away from this. Publicly, I mean.
My sense is we keep all horse wrestling away from the public.
Go to the stables on the south side of the manor. That's where they keep the thoroughbred. Ha! Got it, Lou.
Passing you.
On you go.
Crazy old fool.
If he only knew we just torched his tobacco crop.
That was you?
The old man was cursing the Braithwaites about that.
Burning rich folks' property? Sean was like a pig in shit.
I'm sure. 5,000 for horses. They must be rich.
Yeah, he doesn't know what he's talking about. But to get even a third of that,
how are we gonna play this?
Watch out!
The place is well guarded, so there ain't no point in blasting in there. We'll make them think we're there looking to purchase.
Three armed men?
You'd be armed if you were about to spend 5,000 on horses. We should go in the back way, though. Avoid too many questions.
Speak to him, okay?
All right, then.
Can I help you, gentlemen?
Yeah, we're here to see about some horses.
Horses?
Yeah, we had an appointment with Mr. Braithwaite, I believe.
Yeah, I never heard about any of this.
A partner wanted to make a significant investment in some stables down here. But perhaps we should look elsewhere.
Well, okay, then, but head on up to the stables.
I've got to be all right, man.
Someone will come see you.
Hit him! That's it. Nice and easy. No need to rush. Don't want to draw any unnecessary attention. All right, I think that's the stables just up ahead. Heads down, play cool. Head around the front, hitch up there. All right, let's hitch up here. Real good down there. Let me do the talking. Hello there.
Can I help you boys?
I hope so. Heard you got some horses.
We always got horses.
Fine horses, I mean.
I don't get you, friend.
Yeah, you do. Come on.
Listen, why don't you get out of here? You, Scarface, and your greaser buddy.
Whoa!
I don't like officials.
We ain't officials. We're connoisseurs looking to do some breeding. Come on now, partner.
Okay, fine. Follow me. These here's mainly the studs available for purchase or for working. If that's what you're interested in. What is you boys interested in?
We represent a famous stable and stud farm from Saratoga.
That's so.
unofficially.
Of course. Well, this here's Cerberus. There you go, boy. Cerberus is a real reliable step. Uh-huh, greaser, huh?
Okay, bandana's on. Don't... Nobody recognizes us.
All right, I'll grab the white one in the middle. You get the other two.
Relax, boy. Come on.
Good boy.
Whoa, whoa.
Easy now.
Easy.
Take it easy.
Marston, you're going to tether him up to Javier's horse.
Okay.
Javier, you're going to lead the stallions.
This way. Come on.
Marston, you ride point. I'll cover up the back.
Beautiful
horse.
If there's
any problems, regroup at Clemens Cove. Okay.
What are you doing?
Let's go, quick!
What the hell are you doing? Stop! Stop!
Watch the rear!
Stay with us!
What's going on here? The horse is... That, but not the instead.
More coming this way! Out of the fields! Watch it!
Swap is better now, I've switched to the other one. Oh, missed that shot. What an that one. Wow.
They blocked their way out.
We'll have to go through the field. There's a gap in the fence. We can get up. See if we get rid of them in the trees.
Think we're clear.
Just over there. Come on. Let's get this over with.
Well, thanks.
That could have gone smoother.
That'll be on my gravestone.
Sorry, horse.
You think they look like they're paying $5,000 for horses?
I guess we'll see.
Whoa!
Myself. Beautiful horse.
What you boys want?
Heard you was Heard you paid good prices for horses.
Oh, we'll buy more or less anything, Pop.
That so?
Sure, Pop. I'm Clay Davies. That's my brother Clive. We're twins.
John, sorry.
John. Arthur. Javier.
So what are you? Cuban?
No.
I don't like Cubans.
That so?
Maybe. Why, what do you care? You ain't Cuban.
Maybe I like Cubans.
Ooh, you're funny. He's funny. Ain't he funny, Clive? Clive don't talk. We're twins, but I was born first. He came out all yellow and black, but he's okay.
Sure.
Yeah, I know these horses. They ain't yours. But I like you, and I'll give you... I'd give you 650 for them.
I was told we could get up to $5,000 for them.
And I was told the moon was made of ladies' tears. Only it ain't true. Not one little bit.
But...
I like you boys. But I ain't got more than 700 on me. You want it, or you want to ride them fellas into town, and maybe someone there will hang you.
We're gonna need more than that.
I ain't got no more money, Pop. Here, take it or leave it. Uh-huh.
All right.
You goddamn fool, Marston.
Ain't no one around here got $5,000, boys, but nice meeting you. See you boys again, I hope. Come on, yeah. Close the gate, Clive.
Believe the yarn spun us by one of that Gray family. Imagine we was gonna be wonderfully rich. At the end of it, we felt like prize idiots.
Well, let's have a look at the... Let's just see if I can like the weight. Not putting much in there, are they? Give items as well, okay. I think that's it for today, guys. If you don't enjoy this video, please like and subscribe. And hit the notification bell to start today with all my content.